Welcome to the day in the life of Jamarius Burton. I just finished up with practice. I'm going to take y'all through, you know, a night before a big game. We start off with feeling at roots. So I'm going to take y'all to roots and we're going to get fueled up. Appreciate you.
Thank you kindly.
I'll see you later.
Okay, handle your business tomorrow.
Yes, ma'am. Got the roots. So now we're gonna head home, see the people a little bit. Then I'm gonna go through my routine to get ready to settle down for the night and get ready for the game tomorrow. We just got our roots. You know, we're on the way to see my family. They down here for senior night. So it's gonna be great to see my mom, see my dad, see my people, you know, come down and be a part of the festivities, the senior night. Just a special moment. We on the way to see him. So we just pulled up to the Airbnb. My people here for senior night, so they're staying at the Airbnb and we're just going here, chop it up with them and, you know, have a little time before I go back home and get through my night routine.
All right, I think seeing him and knowing that it's senior day is gonna be very emotional. With everything that he's been through over the past 5 years with his injuries and then coming back and seizing the opportunity to work hard. We're gonna miss it. We're gonna miss seeing him do what he loves to do day in and day out.
Man, it's huge. Our family has always been about education, and whenever you can get a degree, a master's or anything in that area, it's always great.
Number one, his ability to just recognize areas of improvement like almost immediately. I've seen him make adjustments during the game, whether it's on defense, and then just his ability to be more vocal. Like, you know, I've seen that especially more this year. You know, and I think that development over the years from, you know, even middle school, grade school, all the way up to now, he has evolved in that. So, you know, the ability to make those adjustments quickly and then to communicate, you know, effectively with people to really get them to buy in and kind of like jump aboard.
So. One of the things that I thought was really important growing up is that he learned how to articulate his assessment of the game. So one of the things I used to do is I would make him sit down and I will ball up a piece of paper like as if it was a microphone, and he would have to literally answer some questions. And so if he would call me man as he's responding to something that I asked, he would have to literally start over because there were certain words that he was not allowed to say during the interview. So he would have to always be respectful. He would always have to think about what he's gonna say before he actually says it to prepare him for this moment.
Come on, say go, hit, go.
She nervous now. You gotta do it with her mama.
Yeah, maybe she'll get to do it with her mom.
Go, pick, go.
Go, pick, go.
Go, pick, go.
Yeah, he was probably sleeping over there, holding us down.
So,
who talked to you? Something right about this game.
What you mean?
Somebody cheating.
Red.
Look at that big old smile on Jay's face, like, you know what I'm saying? So, the countdown is out.
Oh no.
See?
up.
Wait, time out. No, 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 no.
I ain't even really think about that. Nah, she on something. Like,
nah. Why do you do that? Nobody drawing cars. Like, what is wrong with y'all?
You should have left the other way. I know, I ain't even know.
Right, now you gotta draw.
Four, no, no, that's 4, 8. Then I gotta draw 10.
Oh no.
See. I guess you know what she doing then.
You want a rematch?
No, I don't. I don't. Want that. She done beat me twice.
Just got done with the family at the Airbnb. My brother and his girlfriend gonna come to my crib and hang out with me. So let's go through the night routine.
Let's go.
The thing I like about where I live, man, is going through that tunnel. Like, having the ability to go through the tunnel and out the tunnel every day is just a blessing. Like, when I go through the tunnel and I come out of it, especially in the morning times, like, that's when I really reflect, thank God for allowing me to be in the city of Pittsburgh and, you know, the work that he's done in my life. I just thank him. And we're gonna go through that tunnel pretty soon.
Made it back home. Got my roots so I can fuel up for tonight. Usually when I get home, I feed my sons. See my son? I got 2 turtles and I got 1 fish. So the other one, he kind of hide out at the bottom. But when I come in after a long day, I turn the light on. I usually keep the light on at night so I can have light on. And then I feed the fish a pinch, just a pinch. And then I feed my sons a little bit. You're not supposed to feed them too much. So you can see they both out, they both happy, because they know what time it is. I just enjoy watching them, you know, when I'm chilling. That's Deuce, and that's 11. I could tell them apart. Because Deuce, his ear is darker red. He's a red-eared slider. And then the other one is 11. He's a different type of turtle. His ear, dang, look at them. They fighting. Oh my goodness. They are really going at it about this food. Ooh, he bit his arm. Let go of your brother's arm. Stuff I have to deal with. But yeah, Deuce and 11. I named them after my 2 jersey numbers, of course. And then this fish, I don't have a name for the fish yet. So that's still open. That's out there. So comment a name and I'll name my fish the best name on the comments section. I come home, I chill, I relax, I shower. I kind of converted my living room into a living room / training room. So I got my living room, got my TV, got my couch. Got my bike, got my foot massager. Normatex, obviously need these. Big piece to what I do. Something I invested in, something I think you definitely need as an elite athlete. I have a game ready also. If you don't know, a game ready is like a intense ice and compression machine. I had a knee surgery last year, so definitely something that I feel like I've needed to try to help with my recovery, help me, you know, get back from game to game, practice from practice, and it's just been a blessing to have in my at-home recovery. So I'm a shower up, I'm a relax, cut on some TV, watch a little basketball, and go through my routine a little bit. now that I've showered up and changed, one of the things that I like to do the night before the game is my Ted bar, and I'm gonna take you through that. I usually sit off the edge of the bed, edge of the couch, and I put my feet through here. It's about 25 pounds. It's only about 15 to 10% of my body weight. And I do this at least three sets of 30 every night. Not every night, but the night before the game. And it strengthens my shin muscles, and it helps, it just helps me feel stronger going into the game. So I do three sets of 35 with 25 pound weights every night leading into the game, and it's helped me. So I do this. I'm gonna foam roll a little bit. I'm gonna ice my knee a little bit and put on the boots, fuel up with roots, kick back and watch a game. So typically the night before a game, I fuel up with roots. As you can see, some nice healthy bowl. I put chicken, mushrooms, beets on there, helps with blood flow. Kale, broccoli is good. Some black beans. I just try to keep it real clean and healthy leading into the game. So I'm gonna definitely fuel up with roots and then figure out how much sleep I need. So I also wear a tracker. I wear it on my wrist, and it kind of helps me know how much sleep that I need going into the night before the game. So it said I've, as you can see the app right here, it's Whoop. I wear it religiously every day. You can see, you know, my basketball load, my recovery, everything like that. And typically I look at it the night before the game and really figure out how much sleep I need so I can prepare, you know, the right way. So tonight it says I need 922. I'm gonna just try to get 922, if not more. And I've seen, you know, I've seen how well I feel when I get, you know, how much sleep that it says I need to get. So it's definitely a key staple in my routine and something that I'll continue to use for years and years to come. So that wraps up my night routine leading into a game. Tomorrow's a big day, senior night. Look forward to seeing y'all there. I'm gonna rest up and I'm looking forward to tomorrow.
Just getting started, my story is far from finished. My little brother just came home from doing time. Put a bankroll in his pocket, cause I love.
So, it's the day of the game. We're about to get breakfast at Gussie's, one of my favorite spots on campus, to get my body right for tonight's game. See y'all inside. Got my Gussies. About to head in and shoot around, get up some shots, and get ready for the game. See y'all inside.
Together on three, familiar, six. 1, 2, 3, together. 4, 5, 6, familiar. Yeah, man, 1-0.
Later on tonight.
Come on. Y'all go on three. 1, 2, 3. Together.
Straight, call me dude.